This is Election 88 Update with Jim Heath and Everett Peralta.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Jim Heath, along with Everett Peralta. February 8th, 1988. Today is the Iowa caucus. Now, it is, let me set the stage here. It's 3:45 Arizona time. In 15 minutes, it will be 6 o'clock on the eastern coast, and the caucusing will begin in Iowa. And the caucus could make or break several of the candidates, both Republican and Democrats. We have a lot to talk about tonight in a limited amount of time, so Everett, let's get right into it. Behind us on the bulletin board, you see our predictions. I'm predicting Robert Dole the winner for the Republicans, and you have predicted George Bush barely. Let's talk about that first.
I see a close contest between George Bush and Dole, but Bush will come out a few points ahead.
A few points ahead. I think Dole will win, and I think he'll win substantially by 7, 8, perhaps as much as 10 percentage points. And I think that the real contest tonight is to watch third place. Now, on the Republican side, you and I, the only agreement we have on the Republican side is that we both predict Pat Robertson to come in third. And it's just a question of how close you think Robertson's going to be to Dolan Bush.
I think it's going to be a substantial difference of about somewhere between 5 to 10% difference.
Even though we have Robertson third, I have to say that I think not only will Dole win, but I think there will be a real struggle to come in second between Bush and Robertson. So I think Dole will win substantially tonight on the Republican side, and that Bush and Robertson will fight for second spot. But we do agree, the only agreement we have, the Republicans on both sides of our board here tonight, is that Robertson will come in third. The biggest disagreement I think we have is that I have chosen Kemp to come in fourth. You think he's out of this?
I think that he has not put in the time, the effort, or the organization to come in that high. I think he will come in dead last. And I believe that once the Iowa caucuses are over with, we will see Kim go back to New York and be the representative he was elected for.
So you think, and just to mention that, you think he'll run for Congress again? Because his term is up at the...
I think he will. I think that the man is running for the presidency for the next election.
Okay, and do you mean Iowa or New Hampshire? He'll stick it in through New Hampshire, even if he comes in last year tonight.
He may, but I don't think he'll be of any significance.
Okay, and as for DuPont and Haig, even though we disagree on whether they come in fourth or fifth or fifth or sixth, we both agree that pretty much they're politically dead.
Yes, I think that they're going to give their support to whoever the winner is, and it won't bring in that much difference in the next primary.
Let's Des Moines Register poll, the final one, which was taken over the weekend, shows that Dole has 37%, Vice President Bush 23%, Pat Robertson 13%, Jack Kemp with 11%, Pete DuPont with 7%, and Alexander Haig with 1%. What's interesting is only 8% of the Republicans polled were undecided. So pretty much things have been, at least on the Republican side, Republicans know pretty much who their candidate is going to be.
Jim, if I just may share, that was pretty close to the prediction that ABC made this morning. And I think that that's going to be what most of the surveyors are indicating.
And yet you still think that Bush is going to topple Dole.
I honestly believe that.
I admire that, going against the polls, and quite frankly, the way polls have been in recent past, you're probably going to be correct. We don't put too much reliance on those polls, particularly this early. I mean, who knows what's going on? And I have a feeling deep in my soul that deep down that something is going on across the grassroots, as it does in every presidential election year. I can't get my finger on, particularly on the Republican side, what's happening. Let's quickly go to the Democrats now. You and I agree on the top two here tonight, even though, and I'll go ahead and read the same Des Moines Register poll for the Democrats, Gephardt 25%, Simon in second place with 19%, Dukakis with 15%, Jackson with 9%, and Babbitt with 9%, Gary Hart with 7%, and Al Gore with 1%, but 15% of the Democrats are still undecided, which says that a lot of people have not been overwhelmed by any one of the candidates in Iowa.
I agree with that estimate that they have not been overwhelmed by any of the candidates.
What do you think about the poll showing Simon second? You and I both predicted Gephardt the winner here tonight, or projected him the winner. Dukakis, we both agree, will come in second. I have put Simon third. You have put him fourth.
This morning, ABC reported that they see a dead heat between Gephardt, Dukakis, and Simon I disagree with that poll. I believe that Gebhardt will be the substantial winner, followed maybe 5 to 10 points behind with Dukakis, and then Simon maybe equaling Dukakis. After that, I have real troubles. For instance, I have Simon somewhere in fourth place. My third is Jackson. I think Jackson is the wild card in this race.
Let's talk about Jesse Jackson for just a second, because that's one of our major disagreements. I have projected, again, as we can see in the bulletin board back here, I have projected Jesse Jackson to come in fifth here tonight. You projected him to come in third. I think you're going probably on the basis, if I could just guess, and you'll correct me, of course, if I'm wrong, but I'm going on the basis that you believe that the liberal Iowa voter is going to go and vote for Jesse Jackson.
Well, I honestly believe that, but I have some more evidence that leads me to contend that he will come in at a higher rate than you suggested. I think that he has become presidential. He's got an act about him that's very different from the last time he ran. He shakes hands, he remembers people's names. He's been out there campaigning. And I think that the people are seeing him in a new light, especially with the new economic topics of this election. And so,
I have to admit, I have noticed that. He is sounding presidential, particularly in debates. He's concentrating particularly on foreign policy and domestic policy that sounds like real policy instead of the rhetoric we heard perhaps 4 years ago. As inspiring as it was, I think the definition of presidential was not to be. But this year, Jesse Jackson is truly, I believe, running for the presidency because he wants that nomination. We also have a major disagreement on Al Gore. Now, Albert Gore pulled his entire campaign out of Iowa a month ago, and he has not been back to Iowa, and you have projected him to come in above Hart and Babbitt here tonight.
I think that the South has a real influence on Iowa. I think people are thinking about what's going to happen on Super Tuesday. They also look at him and they see a president. He looks presidential, he acts presidential, and who knows?
Even though he wasn't there.
Even though he wasn't there, the influence is being felt. I think he's a significant influence on this campaign in Iowa, and I think he will make his mark.
I just have to say that that I believe that Iowans probably, again, this is our biggest disagreement, because I think Iowans will be a little upset that he didn't spend the time that the others did, and I think that he'll be rewarded with last place here tonight. We also disagree on, I think, again, another major disagreement, perhaps the most major, is Bruce Babbitt. I have projected him to come in right behind Simon in fourth place. You projected him to come in dead last here tonight. What do you think?
If I have ever seen poor economics at play, it has to be with Bruce Babbitt. This man has spent time, energy, money, organization, and he will come in dead last.
Think so? Although the poll here again, referring to it again, shows that he's tied with Jackson for fourth place.
I don't think he'll come out that high. I think he's an unknown. I don't think he's presidential at all.
And you think that he will not be rewarded with many caucus goers?
No, I don't.
Support here tonight. We agree with Gebhardt and Dukakis on the top of the pack. Below that, we agree only on Gary Hart coming in sixth. Hart, you know, for my side, not to sound like Siskel Ebert or something, but on I believe that he has been honestly campaigning as best he can, but he can't get over that personality factor that although people find him fascinating, people are going to find it very difficult to get up in a caucus and actually go to a corner of the room in support of Gary Hart without probably being ribbed by their friends and their family members.
Well, I think that he is in here basically because he needs to pay some debts. And I think that he will have some influence as the campaign goes on, but Iowa is not hard country anymore. There is no heart in Iowa.
Okay, so just to recaption these, on the Democrat side, we have agreed on Gebhardt and Dukakis coming in first and second. We have disagreed on third. You have gone with Jackson, and I have gone with Simon. On fourth, you have gone with Simon, and I have gone with Babbitt. And then you have put Gore fifth, and I have put Jesse Jackson fifth. Gary Hart, we both agree, has come in sixth. And Bruce Babbitt, you have projected to come in dead last. And Al Gore, I have projected to come in dead last. Quickly, to review the Republicans, Bush and Dole, real close, first and second?
I think so, yes.
And Robertson third?
Yes.
And DuPont and Kemp, we have disagreed. You have chosen DuPont and I have chosen Kemp. You have put Kemp last and Haig fifth, and I put DuPont and Haig fifth and sixth. Now, we have just a few moments left. It's 5 minutes until our C-SPAN coverage begins the Iowa caucus, and I have managed to find a shoebox here. And considering that the race is so close, I thought we'd do what I'd like to call a scientific method of projecting a close race. You remember them doing this in years past?
Oh,
sort of the lottery of projection. Because the race is so close, let's begin with the Republicans first. I have each one of the six Republicans' names written on these pieces of paper. I'm going to deposit them in this genuine shoebox. There's something down there that we can take out, and I will shuffle them around. Ev, I'll ask you to close your eyes here and just draw them out one at a time, and this will be our scientific method.
We show Kemp.
And I know you'll love that projection. This could be a major upset. We have projected with our unscientific method that Kemp will come in first.
Maybe we should do this reverse. Yeah. DuPont?
Boy, I tell you, if the underdogs prevail here tonight, we've got it covered. I'll tell you. DuPont to come in second.
Robertson to come in third. Maybe this should be a reverse order.
No, that's ironic. We both chose Robertson to come in third.
Haig
to come in fourth. That means Bush and Dole are going to come
Bush.
In last. And Dole's going to come in last. Well, maybe we won't use this unscientific method ever again. Because, unfortunately, we have some extra time, we're going to do the Democrats now.
We show Dukakis one.
Now, that's a possibility. We didn't discuss that. Let's halt just a second and mention that if Dukakis does remarkably well here tonight, and he's got the lead in New Hampshire, what kind of impact do you think that will have on the South going into Super Tuesday? Any at all?
I think that if Dukakis wins Iowa, New Hampshire, that Gore, if he comes out the winner, has got a real problem on his hands.
Is Gephardt into that, too? I mean, Gephardt obviously is going to play a factor in both New Hampshire and Iowa. So it could become a three-man race, you think, between Gephardt, Gore, and Dukakis?
I think so. That sounds like a good prediction.
We projected Gephardt and then Simon to come in fourth.
Babbitt
to come in fifth.
Jackson
to come in to fifth, I guess. I don't know where exactly we're going.
Hart,
and then we project Gore to come in last, and I agree with that projection. I think those are pretty close, and boy, we've had fun the last few minutes, haven't we?
Yes. I think I'll stick with my original predictions and let them fly.
Let's, we've still got two more minutes. We will be joining C-SPAN. Any projections? We're going to be with each other next week going into New Hampshire. Who has got to do extremely well here to survive?
Gephardt has to do very well in Iowa and New Hampshire, or from that point on, he can forget it. Dukakis has to do very well in New Hampshire in order to continue in the race. If he does fairly well in Iowa, that's to his credit, and it'll help him more as we go on from there. As far as Jesse Jackson, if Jesse Jackson can maintain second, third place continuously through this convention, he will be the broker. He will be the one that people have to go to, and he will be the one brokering the convention. Simon, I think, is a goner once he comes in either third in Iowa.
Let's just quickly, who's going to be a goner after tonight and perhaps after next New Hampshire primary?
In Iowa, I think the goners are Simon, Hart, and Babbitt.
I would agree with that. I think they'll stick it in through New Hampshire, and then I think they'll be gone next week.
Yeah.
And those are the three. Any Republicans, I project that maybe Haig and DuPont, and those two will be gone by the end of New Hampshire.
I go one step further. I think DuPont is already gone, Haig is already gone, and Kemp will be gone.
And you think Kemp's going to fade away?
Huh? I think he's going to vanish.
What about
the same style that his campaign has?
If Bush gets the nomination, doesn't he fit the bill pretty well for the vice presidential spot?
Well, Kemp is from New York. He's a congressman. He's got some national reputation, but I think that the vice president is going to search for a more powerful individual to attract more.
Jane Kirkpatrick, maybe?
I think he's going to go for a more conservative person than himself, but I'm not sure at this time who that candidate will be.
Okay, we are going to join now the Super Tuesday. Boy, I'm thinking way ahead. The Iowa caucus tonight, February 8, 1988, the first of our major political contests, and it's going to do some making or breaking for some various presidential candidates here tonight. With Everett Peralta, thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Jim.
We'll be back on the other side of this coverage with to look at the ramifications of the different winners and losers. Enjoy our Iowa coverage. Thanks for joining us tonight.
This was Election 88 Update with Jim Heath and Everett Peralta. So remember to subscribe to the Jim Heath channel and hit that like button. Thank you for watching.